skies were gray when it came today and hit the sight of what had passed that night. While the heavens wept their tears for the children of the world, the birds were quiet and the only sounds were the tolling bells and the drums' dead beat. At the funeral that was held for the children of the world, perhaps no one knew just what to say. Being God's, it had to be that way. For a voice had sung inside their heads and told them to lift their hands and slaughter every child in every land. There was no use, no room, no time. There was no need for children, and so it came to the night of the tiger and the end of the children. The children of 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 the world. Laughing, they had ignored their fate. Silent protests were now too late. The deed was done, the price was paid for all the sins of men who had reached the stars and forgot the earth. His pride and wrath, envy and lust, his greed and sloth that lived as they must to the worship of the tiger. Of the children, of the children, of the world. Tears dry from skies that cried a sudden shadow shook through the ground, and from each grave arose a cloud that curled around the world and formed the most terrible tiger of them all. While every being left alive bowed their heads and feared to look on the face of the tiger who had taken